Star Time. And now, without further ado, Mercury Records bring to you live from Sing Sing Prison, the funniest lady in the world, Jackie Moms Mabley.
An excuse for not coming up when Mom was supposed to. Some two men bought a disease over here in this country. And I got that flu. Honey, I was sick. Oh, the doctor come to see me. I said, do something for me, honey. I'm dying. He said, Mom, I said, I can't hear nothing, doctor. Do something for me, please. He said, Mom, just drop your jaws. But first, children, I want to thank this wonderful man that made it possible for Mom to be out up here today. And that's Warden Lehman. Warden, come out here a minute, son. Come on out, baby. Thank you so much for bringing me up here. All of these is Mom's children, and I brought something for you. Two of Mom's latest albums, one called Abraham, Martin, and John, and the other one is called What Generation Grab? Now you just go home and put them on your machine and laugh yourself to death, cause they're funny.
My only concern is to have the men enjoy the show that was what we started out for.
Well, if they don't stand up and laugh, they're gonna do some funny things sitting down, I tell you that. Children, I feel safer than I felt in a long time. Cause baby, it is rough out there. You know, a little boy 10 years old walked up to Mom and said, stick him up. I say, you too little son to be carrying on like that. He said, Mom, I don't want that damn job. Give me some money. It's rough out there. And the weather, you're nice and warm in here and everything. The weather out there, baby, is terrible. Oh, it's awful. I was walking down Fifth Avenue. We just had a big snort walking down Fifth Avenue past the cathedral. And just before I got there, an old woman, real old, older than me, she slipped up right in front of the cathedral, fell bop, right down on the ground. Some man coming down out of the cathedral picked her up, you know. And the old lady said, are you hurt, mother? She said, no, I think I'm all right. She said, she looked up at him and says, is mass out? He said, no, but your hat's on crooked. And during the holidays, oh, it was terrible. You couldn't go nowhere. One man downtown, he run short of bartender, you know. He didn't have no bartender. His bartender got sick. And he had nobody but this little sissy boy. Now, don't you all make like you don't know what I'm talking about. But he was known to steal. You know, he'd steal the man's whiskey. The man wanted everything. The man said, well, I can't get nobody else. I got to use this boy. So he called him up and said, come here. He said, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to give you this job for the holidays. But if I catch you stealing my whiskey, I'm going to take a bottle of it and wrap it over your head. And if I catch you stealing my money, I'm going to beat you and you can't see. See, if I catch you doing anything wrong, remember, I'm going to whoop your head till it ropes like okra. He said, you understand that? He said, yes, sir. Said, yeah, yes, I understand. He said, all right, kiss me and go to work. And you talk about poor people suffering out there. Honey, them apartments and things are so cold. Super was one day said to a man, says, you know, I've been with every woman in this building, you know, since I've been here, except one. The man said, that must be that old grouchy woman on the fourth floor. But honey, that woman got mad. That woman got mad. And she read that super. Said, man, send me up some steel. She said, hey, super, send me some steel. You're the latest man I've ever seen. Put on that bottle and do what you order. How can I take a bath when I ain't got no hot water? Listen, super, or do you want me to call you Joe? Don't you know that weather out there is 20 below? I'm so mad at you that I could scream. Super, send up some damn steam. Cause yesterday, you lied and said the heat was on its way. But I haven't heard a hiss out of that radiator today. Cause I've been cold since yesterday. She said, go away. I don't want to hear a thing you got to say. He said, I know damn well you ain't looking for no rent today. Not after what you called me yesterday. But what do you care? If I cough or I sneeze, I wouldn't give you another damn dime if you fell on your knees. I've got to have heat. Mr. Lindsay, you promised me heat. I don't care what they say, but by my rent I'm gonna pay. I've got to have heat. 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 Thank you, darling. You know, a fella in one of them new buildings down there, you know, one of them new co-ops. He couldn't find his apartment. He get drunk every night when he get off the job. He stop at, you know, the bar, nip too much. Time he got home, he was ready. So he couldn't find his apartment. He go around knocking on all the doors, waking people up, 2 o'clock in the morning, knocking on the door, trying to find his apartment. So he got to be a nuisance. So one of the tenants said to him, says, why don't you put a lantern on the outside of your apartment door? Then you know when to find your apartment, when not to knock on everybody's door. So he said, that is a good idea. So he hung a lantern outside his door. That night he come home stoned. He looked up the hall. He said, that's where I live. Right up there where that lantern is. So that's where I live. He went on up there and took the lantern down. Looked at the door, said, yeah, this is where I live. He unlocked the door and went on in. He said, yeah, I know this is where I live. Yeah, there's the picture on the wall that I put up there. Yeah, there's the bedroom. Yeah, there's my wife in the bed. There's me laying beside her. He said, but who is that damn pool holding the lantern? Taxi cab driver used to take a man to work every night. He'd take his man to work, go back home, get his wife to take to work. So he's on his way to work one morning. The man said to him, said, wait a minute, son, my boy, he said, let's stop here at the saloon and get a little taste. So he said, I ain't got time, see, because as soon as I get you and take you to work, I got to rush back and get your wife and take her to work. He said, man, my wife don't work. He said, don't tell me, man, as soon as I drop you off every morning at your job, I go back and get her and take her to her job. He said, man, my wife don't work. I said, you wrong, somebody's wrong, because my wife don't work. He said, I tell you what to do. So when you take me to work in the morning, I'll give you $50 extra. You go back and get her and take her to work, and then you come and get me and show me where you dropped her all there. Sure enough, next morning, he took the boss to work, and then he went back and got his wife. Took her and put her off where he puts her off every morning, you know. Then he went and got the boss and took him and showed him where he put her off at. He said, go in there and get him. So he went in there and stayed about 3 or 4 minutes. He heard all of this loud noise and fighting and carrying on. After a while, yeah, he come out, drag her up to the cab. So he said, that ain't my wife. He said, no, that's mine. I'm going back and get yours. So they scared me so bad. I was on the train, and it was an absent-minded professor on there. He couldn't think of nothing. Couldn't remember nothing. So he had a little black book, and he had everything wrote down in the little black book, you know. So he's sitting up there on the train. Man to him says, hey, traveling professor, says, have you ever been to Pittsburgh? He said, Pittsburgh, took out his little book. He said, yes, I've been to Pittsburgh. Say, did you happened to meet a woman by the name of Lena Smith in Pittsburgh. He said, Smith, took out his book. Yes, I remember. I met a woman by the name of Lena Smith in Pittsburgh. He says, did you have an affair with a woman in Pittsburgh named Lena Smith? He said, affairs. Yes, I had an affair with a woman in Pittsburgh named Lena Smith. He said, well, I'm Mr. Smith and I don't like it. He said, opinions. He said, I didn't either. Remember, of course the world knows it, I don't like no old men. Yeah. I'm going with Tom Jones now. Yeah, I know he's white, but I ain't got time to look for no damn color. When you get old and mom is, you glad to get used as you can. That old man like to run me crazy, children. I don't want nothing old but some old money. And I'm gonna use it to put a head in the paper for some young man. My old man was sitting under a tree and some of the leaf fell on him and knocked him out. He got up on the scales to weigh it, and the scales didn't move. Come saying to me, he said, baby. I said, don't come call me baby, you know my name. He said, now there you go. He said, come on, let's sit down and talk things over. I said, you're gonna have to do more than talk, honey. To get meddling, because I don't believe nothing you say. He said, well, come on, sit down. I sit him down, and then I sit down. He said, Annika looked at me, and said, now, tell me, where are you going to find? He said, just tell me where you're going to find another man like me. I say in the graveyard. Say, what man can you find that'll treat you like I do? I say, Hitler. He said, if I should die, what would you do? I said, laugh. He said, well, I ain't gonna argue with you. I'm going upstairs and go to bed. I said, well, you have to wait a while because I'm tired. I don't feel like carrying you up the steps right now. He said, I got an idea. I said, wait a minute, let me carry you up the steps before you forget it. He forgot it before he got halfway up the step. He's got an idea. Oh, I couldn't stand him. He kept up by. If I thought you'd go in with anybody after I die, I'd roll over in my grave. After he died, I went out that next decoration. Dave tried to find his grave, but couldn't find it nowhere. He done rolled all the way down to the gate. Children, I've wrote an opera. There's things that you can't just stumble into. You got to get ready for it. Luther, the opera. Now, wait a minute, Luther. Wait a minute, Luther. I don't know what's the matter with that boy. I don't know. Luther, I think he's sick. Yes, he's sick. Luther, I want you to play an opera like you'd play for a real opera star. These children all know opera. I want you to play for one of them big, like you play for one of them big opera stars. Like little Stevie Wonder, one of them opera stars. The old man's opera. I wrote strictly for him. You're just too old to be true. There's nothing weaker than you. I have to grab you and shake just to keep you awake. There's nothing more I can do. You're just too far gone to be true. The way he mumbled when he walked. The way he stumbled when he walked. The way he tripped on every crack. The peat moss growing on his back. The way he didn't have a tooth. The lies he told about his youth. The way he snored when he's in bed. That's when I went upside his head. His bottle broke when he fell down. He sat there looking like a clown. The way the wine flowed like the way he screamed, I hope it's blood. The way his screams filled the room, that's when I hit him with the broom. Remembering all those stupid things, all of a sudden my heart sang, you're just too weak to be true. I'm sorry I ever met you. Why don't you give me a break? And just go jump in the lake. I just can't put up with you. You're just too sad to be true. My old man, there's nothing that he's weaker than. If you want a sexy friend, you better not depend on my old man. That old wreck. But what more can you expect? He can't hear and he can't see. He's just here to upset me. Talk about my old man. My life with him is so cold and dreary. How I wish that I could roam children, my life could be so cheery if it wasn't for that old wreck at home. But don't give me no home where the buffalo roam, 'cause that's something Mom never could stand. You just show me a home where the buffaloes roam, and I'll show you. Dirty old man. Now, children, mommies tried by the help of God to make you happy, all of you happy. And now, Mom's gonna drop down in her bed. And show you where Mom's at. I want you, son, I want you to swing. Swing me in the spirit. Let Mom really stretch out. Let it all hang down. Go ahead, right. On the mountain, over the hill, and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ was born. Children, go tell it on the mountain, over the hill, and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ was born. I once was blind, but now I see. Ah, 'twas grace that brought his love to me, and grace will set me free. Go tell it, everybody pat your hand. Over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ. I want you to go tell it on the mountain, over the hill and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ was born. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I want you to go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ. Son, I want you to go tell it on the mountain, over the hill, and everywhere. I want you to go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ has come. Go tell it on the mountain, over the hill, and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ was born. That Jesus Christ was born. That Jesus, oh Lord, Lord. That Jesus, the Savior Christ was born. And kin folks, because nearly everybody in Washington's kin to me. And my old man but got around. I'm telling you, I'm glad to be at home. And I had my first real meal in months. My niece cooked me some hog maw and some crackling cornbread. And a few greens on the side. Thank you, Lord, I'm talking to people that know what I'm talking about. You know, my uncle got, I went down to see him. I always try to see my folks. Got a farm down in Maryland, chicken farm, you know. He ain't been doing so good. No, he'd been, had to mix a little sawdust in with the bran that he fed the chickens, you know, to drive them. You know, I went down to see him, he was so glad. And the day I was down there, a man come by, that lucky man come by, Unc said I was lucky to him. Man come by and ordered 100 hens. And Unc didn't have but 99. He said, I ain't gonna miss this order. I love this parrot, but this is one time he's going. He told him he never did 99 hens and mix him all up, you know, so the man wouldn't notice him. Load them on the back of the truck, and the man paid him. The man got on the road about 5 miles. He looked back, and all the hens was walking. Walking! Old parrot standing on the back of the truck. He said, well, you know, as soon as you make up your mind, you girls can ride. A junkie was walking down 7th Street with a live monkey on his back. I have to pass by him. He said, lady, will you please get this cat out from under me? this cat was coming back from down to Texas. He'd been down to San Antonio to see his mother-in-law. I'd never seen his mother-in-law before. He went down there with his wife in a brand new Cadillac on the way back to New York. So he stopped in a little filling station in Texas, in one of them little towns. He said, "Fill it up, fella." "So wait a minute, what are you talking about, boy?" "I said, fill it up, fella." "He said, you know where you at. Do you know? You're in Texas, boy. And to prove it to you and to give you a little demonstration," he took a silver dollar out, flipped it up in the air, out with his pistol, put a hole right through the middle of his voice and hit the ground. Colored fella looked around and said to his wife, "Honey, hand me one of them apples out that bag." He took the apple, threw it up into the air, out with his switchblade, peeled it, cored it, cut it up into 100 pieces and tossed it in his hand. The white fella said, "How much gas you want, master?" "Better check your oil, too, first." I never forget old Red Fox told us on the Bob. Say, "Folks, you colored folks, my friends, don't get mad when you pass through a suburban town and see those beautiful split-level houses with the little black iron man standing out in the front yard. Don't get mad. Get you some money. Build you a split-level house and put a little white boy out there." Woman had 10 girls on her husband. At last she gave birth to a boy. He says, "Oh my goodness, I'm so glad." Oh, he was so happy. He bought everybody drinks, went on the job giving everybody cigars. "I got me a boy. Got me a boy, lad. 10 girls, now I got me a boy." You know, it's always some drag around. The drag says, "Hey, man, come here." He said, "You sure that's your boy? You around here spending your money buying cigars and stuff. You better go home and ask your wife again." He said, "Man, I guess you're right." He went home and said, "Hey, Becky, come here." He said, "Becky, I want two. Becky, I don't want no food. I want, Becky, I want your head in the ropes like okra. I'm telling you, Becky." "Say, is that my boy? Don't lie to me, Becky. Is that my boy?" She said, "Yeah, Daddy, that's your boy. I swear that's your boy. Anything you want me to, Daddy, that is your boy." "I don't know about the 10 girls." Got me a plane, went to Washington. Walked up on the White House lawn, just as I started up to go in the door, I happened to spy him coming across from the House of Representatives. I said, "Hey, Lyndon. Lyndon, son. Lyndon, come here, boy." To get something colored up in the air quick. "Quick, son. Hurry up and do it. I'm telling you now, for Martin Luther King digs it, and he'd be marching on your buns." I told him. He said, "Mom, I'm so glad you told me. I don't know what to do. What would I do without you? I hadn't thought about that." He said, "Where can I get the biggest crowd of men together in a hurry?" I said, 125th Street and 7th Avenue. "You can get anything you want on 125th Street and 7th Avenue. He put all in the newspaper, all on radio and television. Next Thursday, on 125th Street and 7th Avenue, they're going to choose the first colored astronaut. Honey, it was 3,000 men gathered out of there. 3,000. The man walked out on the platform. He says, I never saw such bravery in all my life. Look at these 3,000 brave men, fearless men, ready to go up for their country. Says, I don't know which one to choose, but to be fair, I'm going to throw this feather out. And whoever it lights on will be the first colored man to go up in there after that. He threw the feather out. You should have seen them 2,000 cats. A cat was driving for an old lady. I wonder how I'm bored. Chauffeur. Driving for this old rich lady. And she get drunk all the time. She get drunk. So she said to him, take me home, Willie. I'm drunk. So he took her home, got to the door. She says, pull off my coat. So Willie pulled off her coat. Pull off my dress, Willie. Willie pulled off her dress. She said, pull off my girdle, Willie. Willie pulled off her girdle. She says, and never let me catch you with them on again. You understand? With his wife. He reached back in his back pocket. His wife jumped up and said, wait a minute. Wait just a minute. Before you start cutting his shoes. Do you see that man laying there? Say, you see that suit you got on? Say, that man bought that. Say, you see this house that we live in? Say, that man paid this. You say, you see that car there in the driveway that you ride out of women around in? Say, that man bought that car. He said, well, baby, you better pull the cum up on him. You might catch cold. Woman had 9 children. While old man in court for non-support. Her and all 9 of the children sitting up there. He was sitting up there with his legs crossed, with a piece of cigar butt in his mouth, grinning, looking all simple. You just say, lady, tell in your own way, just in your own way, your story. She said, Judge, Your Honor, yeah, I have a hard time. When that woman got to talking, baby, everybody in that courthouse was crying. Judge was crying. Judge said, lady, you know what I'm going to do for you? I'm going to see that you get $80 each and every week. He jumped up and said, well, that's mighty nice of you, Judge. I'll try to give a couple of dollars myself. Business of your own. I don't know how. I don't guess I've been to the bank about 6 months. And so I've gone on a little vacation, going down North Carolina, saving folk. So I went down to the bank to get a little money. So a president friend of mine, he took me around, introduced me to the boy on the desk. Say, this is Mom. Say, she wants some traveler's checks. Wait on her. Give her what she wants. So he said, how much do you want? I see about $400 in traveler's checks. He said, what denomination, Mom? I said, Baptist. Two fellas walking down the street. One of them stuttered. He said, hey, boy. Hey, my man. Look at that girl with them pretty legs. He said, where? He said, oh, she gone now. Walked down a little further, he said, oh, man. My man, look at that's not so good. Woman with a pretty little name. He said, where? Oh, she gone too. He said, wait, he walked down about the block. He said, He said, oh, I seen it. He said, well, if you seen it, what'd you step in it for? Some men went out all over the world looking for the oldest man in the world. The oldest man living, they wanted to find him. They went all overseas, all over in Asia, everywhere, and come back in Mexico, and they happened to look way up on one of them high cliffs, and they saw a little shriveled up man. They say he's all bent over. Say, this must be the oldest man in the world. They went up there with their cameras, you know, and their mic and everything. And they said, oh, how do you live this long? I know you got to be the oldest man in the world. What do you do? He said, I drink 7 bottles of tequila every 2 days. And I got 9 women. See, you? See, how old are you? He said, I'm 39. But man, you talk about a cat. Down at the Greyhound bus station, though, this cat waiting for a bus to go to New York. He'd walk around the station. You seen one of them little machines, you know, like you put a dime in or a nickel in and get your fortune told, you know, and also get your weight. So he went and stepped up on the scale, put a dime in, little card come out, say, you are a Negro, your weight is 185 pounds, you're on your way to New York, your bus leaves in 20 minutes. He said, can you beat that? I know somebody looking in my pocket, knowing that much about my business. And he happened to look over and he saw an Indian standing in front of one of the cigar stands, you know, the Indian had all his headpiece and everything. He said, hey, Indian, say, come here a minute. I'm gonna see about this. Indian came over, he said, here, I want to put a dime in there. Give me see how much you weigh. Get up on them scales there. So the Indian got up on the scales, he put the dime in. Card came out, says, you're an Indian. You're from the Cherokee tribe. Your weight is 146 pounds. You'll soon be going back to the reservation. Indian looked at him and said, He said, well, I'll be doggone. I've seen, they tell me they got some, how to, say, Indian, lend me that thing you got on your head a minute in that blanket. the cat took the headpiece and put on his head, pulled it way down, wrapped his blanket around him, way up around his ears, you know, like this. Tipped up on the scale, dropped a dime in, card came out, said, "You're still a Negro. Your weight is 165 pounds. You was on your way to New York, but you fooled around with that damn Indian and missed your bus." Walking down the street crying. Old man walked up to him. Said, "Little boy, why you cry?" Little boy said, "'Cause I can't do what the big boys do." Old man cried too. Here it is. Mom just got back from down there. Behind the scorch curtain. Selma. While I down there, here, heard him give a boy a letter to tell. Well, them tests I have to go through for this boat. This boy has to be a college graduate, see? He went up to the desk, fell to the man, and says, "Let me hear you say the Constitution back hurts." Now, he's giving a literature test. He's talking about the Constitution backwards. He said the Constitution backwards. "So let me hear you say the Old and the New Testament, forward and backwards." He said it forward and backwards. He give him a Chinese newspaper and say, "Let me hear you read that paper." Fella looked at it. He said, "What did it say? What did it say?" He said, "Make no difference what I do, you ain't gonna let me vote no how." Color fella down hope, died, went up to the gate. Say, Peter looked at him and said, "What you want?" "Your man, you know me. Jack, you know me. I'm old Sam Joe. Old Sam Joe, man, you know me. You be with the NAACP and, you know, Cole and all that stuff, man. Marshall, you remember me? Oh, man, you know me. You get your book down there, you know me." He looked in the book, Sam Jones. He said, "Ain't no, you ain't no Sam Jones." He said, "Oh, man, yes, I am. Look there. You know me. I'm the cat that married that white girl on the Capitol step in Jackson, Mississippi." He said, "How long ago has that been?" He said, "About 5 minutes ago." Walking down 126th Street on my way to work. Met a fella. He said, "Mom, I hate this. I really hate this, but Mom, give me some money. Yeah, I ain't got no home. I ain't got no family, no children, no wife. My mother and father are dead. Say, Mom, give me some money. I ain't got nowhere to eat. I ain't got nowhere to sleep. Yeah, I ain't got nothing, Mom. But this gun." some of my hometown people been talking about me. They even said that I'd president. I'm not president. I'm not. But I don't like no old man. I don't give a damn what color he is. Nothing but a child, and either dead as a donail. Don't be like my old man was. I told him one day, I said, you're sick, why don't you take out some insurance? He said, I ain't gonna take out a damn bit. He said, when I die, I want it to be a sad day for everybody. His suspenders was bigger than he was. That's the truth. And he was so weak. One day he went to pop his finger and broke his wrist. A pancake and got lockjaw. I said to him one day, I said, we were invited up in the country for the weekend. I said, you know anything about the country? He said, sure.
I know all about the country. In fact, I used to live in the country when I was a boy.
I said, when you was a boy, everybody lived in the country. Years old and start to drinking. Ain't that something? I told him, I said, don't you know every time you go into a bar, the devil go in there with you?
He said, if he does, he buys his own drink.
Oh, I'm so glad he did. I don't know what to do. One day I said to him, I said, I'm going to give you a little demonstration. I went outdoors and I got a worm. And I put it in a glass of water. The little worm swim all around the glass of water. I took that same worm and put over in a glass of whiskey. The little worm was in that glass of whiskey about 2 minutes and keeled over dead. I said, what does that prove? What does that prove?
He said, it proves if you drink whiskey, you won't have worms.
Man said to me one night, we dropped in the movie, he took me to the movie. But we went to the movie, we both sat in the same seat, he wasn't no bigger than that. He's so old and dried up, he could have sat on a straw. And of all things, was the love picture, a movie picture, a love, when them love scene, he comes scratching my hand. I say, you kidding?
That's all right, when I die, I'm coming back to scratch your eyes out.
I buried him with his face down. The more he scratched, the further away he'll get. my opera. I'm an operatic who is still operating. Luther, the opera. Now that the job is done, Congress in Washington say that we're going to have a new day. No more sweat and strain. All chances are the same. I thank God I live to see this new day. Why, from Maine to California, let me warn you, you got your rights. Use them. Don't be left out. Lift up your head and shout, here's the last of new day. Lego Bocho, Hilly Booty Wow. Since Congress passed the practice rule, you can be a hustler, a scholar, or a fool. It's up to you. Hitch up your wagon to any old star, cause brother, you're to blame now for whatever you are. It's up to you. For instance, you can have money, or spend it, go right on trying to jive or end it. Ain't nobody to blame for what you do but you. But why be an Indian when you can be a chief? Just get up off your and get off relief, that's all. It's all up to you. I'm preaching the sermon today, and this is what I've got to say. All the states are doing fine below the Mason-Dixon line, but Alabama and Mississippi, even down to Alabama, they could be acting like a lamb, but Mississippi, still flipping. Why don't they join the Union and forget the Civil War? What are they waiting for? So listen, Mississippi, if you don't want to come up missing, while you're in your right mind, leave that Delta behind. But should you come up to New York to be free, here's some of the hurting things you're liable to see. There they go, throwing cans and bricks, breaking out the window, stealing just for kicks. A bunch of stupid people acting like a jerk and too damn lazy to go to work. While here we are, just fighting for the cause. There they go, breaking all the laws. A bunch of wild children just acting like a fool and too damn dumb to stay in school. Now, please don't get offended at what Mom's saying. I love you and just don't want to see you acting that way. Not while we are climbing freedom's ladder. Children, we are climbing freedom's ladder. We are climbing freedom's ladder. We're soldiers for us. Everybody now, don't you want to join us? Now don't you want to join us? I say don't you want to. Well, all right then. Good night, my darling. Bless your heart.